Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta. Today we are going to solve each and every question of the exercise 4.4 class 9 NCERT Mathematics. Before to start the exercise 4.4, we have to take its examples. We have to solve one by one each example, because as you already know, examples are the basically concepts that we have to follow to solve the exercise questions. So in this, the whole concept is based on one theorem which is called factor theorem. Please read the statement, what it state. Please read the statement. Factor theorem: if P of x is a polynomial of degree n is greater than or equal to 1, it means if you have a polynomial which is basically a dividend polynomial whose degree is greater than or equal to 1, it means the polynomial may be a linear or greater than, it means it may be quadratic, cubic and may be n, but it should be a linear, not a constant polynomial. And a is any real number. You know what's a real number is? Any number whose square is positive is called a real number. Natural number, whole number, integer number and rational number, all are your real number. So a is what? Your real number. Then we have two cases. First case is what? X minus a is a factor of the polynomial if p of a is equal to 0. It means if any question asks you to check whether this one is a factor of the given polynomial or not, how you can check? By using this first case. If this one is a factor of the polynomial, then if you put the value a in the polynomial, we get is equal to 0. If the result is 0, then you can say that this is a factor of the given polynomial. This can be very clearly you can do by taking an example. That's why I am giving an example 1. What you have to check, examine whether x plus 2 is a factor of this polynomial. So what it said, you have to check this is a factor of this given polynomial, yes or no. This is a basic first example we have to do. Now first, second case is what? If you have a polynomial value on which polynomial becomes 0, it is possible only when x minus a is a factor of the polynomial. It states that if you get a polynomial particular real values is equal to 0, it means that real value belongs to your factor. So if the polynomial at a is equal to 0, it indicates that x minus a is a factor of the polynomial p of x. So please read the second example. What I am going to take, find the values of k if x minus 1 is a factor of the polynomial. Please read this. If x minus a is a factor of the polynomial, please read it. If x minus 1 is a factor of this polynomial, it means if we have given this condition, so we can use this condition, polynomial is equal to 0, because we already know x minus 1 is a factor. So at x is equal to 1, we get a polynomial is equal to 0 according to factor theorem. I hope you understand this concept. I am going to solve this concept very easily. Please make a note first. So now I am going to solve our first case. Examine whether this is a factor. So what we have to do? We have to check this is a factor. Factor means we are talking about divisor polynomial. Because factor is what? Factor is basically your divisor. So we have divisor. G of x is what? Divisor polynomial, which is what? X plus 2. And we have to check whether this is a factor. So this one becomes your dividend polynomial, and dividend polynomial is represented by P of x. This is what x cube plus 3x square plus 5 into x plus 6. Now what are the steps? First step is put divisor polynomial equal to 0. Put g of x is equal to 0. Now put it x plus 2 is equal to 0. If we take 2 on the right hand side, we get x is equal to negative 2. Now second step is what? We have to put x is equal to minus 2 in the dividend polynomial. Dividend polynomial is what? P of x. So we have to calculate P of x, and the values of x is here minus 2. X means we have to put minus 2 whole cube plus 3 into minus 2 whole square plus 5 into minus 2 plus 6. Now solve this. Minus 2 whole cube, minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2, we get minus 8 plus 3 into minus 2 square plus 4, 5 into 2 minus 10 plus 6. Now minus 8 plus 4 is 12 minus 10 plus 6. Minus 8 minus 10 minus 18, 12 plus 6 18, and 18 minus 18 we get 0. And according to theorem first case, if this is a factor of the given polynomial, so when we put this value in the polynomial, we get 0. So in this, what we get? We get 0. So P of minus 2 is 0. So answer is what? Yes, this is a factor. So answer is yes, this is a factor according to your factor theorem. You can also write according to factor theorem. I hope you understand the first case. Now I will take next case. Before, please make a screenshot or take a note. Now look at the second example. Find the values of k. If x minus 1 is a factor, factor means divisor polynomial. So I am writing here divisor g of x is what? X minus 1. And what is your dividend? P of x is what? Is a factor of this. So this becomes your dividend polynomial. What is dividend polynomial? 4x cube plus 3x square minus 4 into x plus k. So please match this. If this is a factor, so it means if we put this value into the polynomial, we get is equal to 0. And if we compare it, x minus a is compared with x minus 1. So what? The values of a is 1. And you can also calculate by the another method. Put divisor is equal to 0. Put g of x is equal to 0. X minus 1 is equal to 0. If we take minus 1 on the right hand side, we get x is equal to 1. And at this value, the polynomial is equal to 0. Because we already know this is a factor. According to what? According to factor theorem. So we are going to solve this equation. Firstly, we have to put x is equal to 1 in the polynomial. P of 1. Now put x is equal to 1. What we will get? 4 into 1 cube plus 3 into 1 square minus 4 into 1 plus k. And we know this one, P of 1 is what? This is equal to 0. So I am writing here 0. 4, 1 cube is 1, plus 1 square is also 1. 4 into 1, 4 plus k. 4 into 1, 4 plus 3 minus 4 plus k. Now 4 is cancelled out with 4 because plus and minus 4. We get 3 plus k. Now what's the values? In this case we have to take 3 on the left hand side. We get k is equal to minus 3. So that is your final answer. This is the second case of the factor theorem. I hope you understand this concept because it's very very easy. Please make a note, then we will proceed to our next question. So our next part is to factorize the polynomials. I am going to take a polynomial of degree 2, which is your quadratic polynomial. So how we will get the factorizations? By using our simplest method, which is called middle term splitting method. We already discussed this topic, so we have to do as fast that we can do. And those students which still not have able to calculate or to do factorization, now we have to use middle term splitting method. What's the middle splitting method? In this you have to check what is your middle term. Middle term is 17. You have to do its two factor, which is called a middle term splitting method. The factor should be in a manner, if we add we get middle term. And if we multiply, we get this multiplication result. 6 into 5, which is 30. And what's the middle term is here? 17. What's the logic is here? Firstly, you have to write general quadratic equation px square plus bx plus c. You have to split the middle term into two factors. If we add them, we get middle term b, and if we multiply, this one is a into c, we get a into c. In this case a is 6 and c is 5. So 6 into 5 we get 30. So what are the factors we have to split? 17 is split into two parts, and if we do add them we get 17, and if we do multiply we get 30. So what are the factors? Plus 15 and plus 2. Please add it. Plus 15 plus 2, we get plus 17. So we get plus 17. This is correct. Now to multiply, plus 15 into plus 2, we get plus 30. So here we get plus 30. It means our factor is correct. What you have to do? We have to take variable also with this factor. So what's the variable is here? X. So I am going to take 15x and this one is 2x. So please write in this format. We get 6x square plus 17x is written as 15x plus 2x, and this 5 is as it is. Now we have to do further factorization so that we can get common from two terms. To try to do, find common of first two terms and then try to find out common in next two terms. So in this term, what we have common? Now this is our first question, so I am doing a very explanation view. I am solving each and every step. Please try to do its factor. 6 can be written as 3 into 2, and this x square is basically what? x into x. 15 can also be written as 3 into 5x, because 3 into 5 is 15, and 2x is written as 2 multiply x, and 5 is written as 5 into 1. Now try to do solve by taking common. What's the common in this 3 and also 3? So we can take 3 as a common. Now next term is in this 2x, x into x, but in this case we have only 1x, so we can take 1x as a common. So I am going taking as a x as a common. So remove these two terms, 3 and x. If we remove 3 and x, what we will get here? 2 and 1x, 2x. If we remove 3 and x, what we will get? Only 5. Same here, but there is no common. So if you get no common, so you can get 1, because 1 is a factor of all the numbers that you can take common. So I am going to take 1 as a common. If I take 1, the remaining terms remain same. So we get 2x plus 5. Now what we have to do? This is your first term and this is your second term. In this you also take common. What are the common is? 2x plus 5, 2x plus 5. Both have the same term, 2x plus 5 in both the terms. So I am going to take 2x plus 5 as a common. If I take 2x plus 5 as a common, what's the term remains? Only 3x. So I am writing 3x. If we take plus, here if we take 2x plus 5 common, then we will get only 1. So that's why we have get only 1. So this is what? This is your final factors. These are the factors of the given polynomial. So I explain each and every step, but you try to do in very quickest way, because such type of questions will ask in your exam as a 1 marks or 2 marks. So try to do very fast. So this is our second. In this you have to do fast. What's our middle term is? Minus 5. So we have to split in two parts. If we do multiply, we get what? 1 into 6, we get 6. And if we add, what we will get? Middle term, minus 5. Now you have to assume two number. If you add them, we get minus 5. If we do multiply, we get plus 6. What are the number? Minus 3 and minus 2. Now add minus 3 and minus 2 is minus 5. And if you multiply minus minus plus, 3 into 2, 6. We get plus 6. So what we have to do? We also add x, because sorry, in this we have to use variable y, because the polynomial is y. So it's very easy. Now write this: y square minus 3y minus 2y and plus 6 as it is. We split minus 5 into two parts, minus 3y and minus 2y. Now take it common, because in this we have 2y, y into y, but in this only 1y, so we can take y as a common. If we take y as a common, then what will be remains? Only y, minus 3. If we take here y as a common, we get only minus 3. Same here. Now in this case there is no common, but try to do common, find out how to do. This is 2 into 1 and this is what? 6. You can write in terms of 2, 2 into 3. So 2 into 3. Now do y minus 3. Now what are the common? 2, but the sign is here minus, so I am take minus 2 as a common. So if we take minus 2 as a common, the what's the term remains? Y, but the sign is here positive. If I take negative common, the sign becomes changed, so it becomes negative and if we take 2, we get only 3. Now, if we take these two terms as a common y minus 3, if I take y minus 3 as a common, what the terms remain here? Y, and we get here minus 2. So this is our answer, this is your factor, this is called the middle term splitting method. Please make a note. Our next question, example 5, factorize. This is the same question as we already did in first previous examples, but in this we have to use to find out the factorization, or you have to do factor, but by using factor theorem, not using a middle term splitting method. What's the logic? How to get the factorize of the polynomial by using factor theorem? It is basically hit and try. And how you will get hit and try? Please make a note. Firstly, you have to check it. What is your constant term? Your constant is what? 6. Now you have to do its factor, and we know that what's the factor of 6 is, we can write 1 multiply 2 multiply 3. You can also do by using prime factorization method. 2 3 is a 6, 3 3 is a 1, it means we get 1 2 3 as a factor. So we have to do start from 1 2 and 3 and check whether the polynomial becomes 0. If the polynomial becomes 0, it means that one is your factor. Please make a look first. Our first factor is what? I am taking case 1. 1. So try to do plus minus 1. So firstly, I am taking, because the variable in this case is y, so I am going to take y is plus minus 1. So first is, I am taking y is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1. It means we have to put y is equal to 1. Y is equal to 1. Now solve this. 1 square minus 5 into 1 plus 6. 1 minus 5 into 5 plus 6. 6 plus 1, 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, and which is not equal to 0. So y is not your, 1 is not your factor. Now you have to check next, minus 1. Y is equal to minus 1. Now put minus 1 square minus 5 into minus 1 plus 6. Minus 1 into minus 1, we get 1. Minus 5 into minus 1 plus 5 plus 6, it means we get 12, and 12 not equal to 0. It means 1 and minus 1 is not the factor of this polynomial. Now our next step is, we have to check our next factor is plus minus 2. So before to further solve, please make a note first. Now we have to take our second case. Second case is what? Put y is equal to plus minus 2, because second factor is our 2. Put y is equal to 2. Now solve it. Y is equal to 2. 2 square minus 5 into 2 plus 6. 2 square is 4, minus 5 into 2, 10 plus 6. 6 plus 4, 10 minus 10. It means we get 0. So y is equal to 2 is the factor of the given polynomial. Now you have to check third. Y is equal to negative 2. Put negative 2, minus 2 whole square minus 5 into minus 2 plus 6. Minus 2 whole square is 4. Minus 5 into minus 2, 10 plus 6, which is 20, not equal to 0. So this is a factor, but this is no, as we already know, because this is a quadratic equation and quadratic equation has a degree 2 and number of factor is also 2. So we get here up only one factor. It means one another factor also exists for this polynomial. Now we have to do our third, y is equal to plus minus 3, case third, y is equal to plus minus 3. Now solve it. I am taking y is equal to plus 3, put in 3 square minus 5 into 3 plus 6. Now solve. 3 square is 9, minus 5 3 is 15 plus 6, 9 plus 6 15, minus 15 which is 0. It means yes, this is also a factor. Now what you have to check, our next, y is equal to minus 3, but it's your option because we already know we have got only two factors. You can also verify by putting y is equal to minus 3. Now put y is equal to minus 3, minus 3 square minus 5 into minus 3 plus 6. Minus 3 square is 9 plus 15 plus 6 which is 30, not equal to 0. This means no. What are the two factors? First factor is y is equal to 2. First factor is y is equal to 2, and second factor is what? Y is equal to 3. Now how you can write in terms of factorized form? Please move it on the left hand side. We get y minus 2. Same here, move this 3 on the left hand side, we get minus 3. So y minus 2 and y minus 3, this is your factor by using factor theorem. If someone question asks you to solve or to factorize the given polynomial by using factor theorem, then you have to use this concept. Please make a note. Now I am going to take example 6. In this I am going to take a cubic polynomial. It is something complex, so please make a look very carefully. We have to factorize x cube minus 23x square plus 142x minus 120. We have to use in this factor theorem. By factor theorem, what we have to do? We have to try to find out its constant term. What's the constant term is here? Constant term is what? 120. And you know what's the factor of 120 is what? If we do use prime factorization method, 260, 230, 215, 3 5s are 15, 5 5s are 1. It is basically prime factorization, but you have other factors also. You can write so many factors, like so factor of 120 is what? We can write so many factors like plus minus 1, plus minus 2, plus minus 3, because every factor, if we divide, because if we divide 120 by 1, we get remainder 0, it means 1 is your factor. If we divide by 2, 120 by 2, we get 60, so 2 is also factor because remainder is 0. If we divide by 3, 120 by 3, we get 40, so remainder is again 0. So all these are factors. You can write so many factors, plus minus 4, plus minus 5, plus minus 6, because every factor divide the 120 and we get 0. So these are the factors of 120, but we have so many numbers. But try to do your starting number, because we get easily solution from the starting number. So our first value is 1. The variable is here x. So I am taking case 1. Put x is equal to plus minus 1. So firstly I have to put x is equal to 1 and check whether this is a polynomial or a not. Put it, x is equal to 1 cube minus 23, 1 square plus 142 into 1 minus 120. Solve this. 1 minus 23 into 1 square is 1 plus 142 into 1, 142 minus 120. Now solve 1 into 142, we get 143. Now 120 and 23 we get minus 143, it means we get 0. So at x is equal to 1 we get 0. You have to do only find out first 0. So you, if we not get here 0, then we will take x is equal to minus 1. In that case, if we did not get the values of the polynomial is 0, then we have to try x is equal to 2 and x is equal to negative 2, x is equal to 3 and negative 3 and so on. But it's very easy to find very close number 1, 2, you will get the solution. So in this what we have get, our first factor is what? X is equal to 1. Now do the same step to take this right side number on the left hand side. So we get x minus 1, this is a factor, but we know this is a cubic polynomial, so degree is 3. So what are the factor is also 3, but this even is your only single factor. Now we have to find out two another factors, and that factor how we can calculate or find, please make a note first. Now we already got our first factor, now we have to find another two factor, and the method that we have going to apply to find out two another factors, we have two types of method. It's your choice, you can use either of these two method, which one is easy for you, you can apply. I'm taking first method, please first method. To find another factors, another two factors, how we can find, please write your first dividend polynomial. I am writing dividend polynomial, x cube minus 23 x square plus 142 x minus 120. In this you have to keep it in your minds, you have to make all the terms as a factor of this, because we have already a one factor x minus 1, so we have to try to make all these terms in terms of a factor x minus 1, so that we can take x minus 1 common to all these terms. Then how can we make, please make a list. In this we have x cube and I want to make it as x, so we have to take x square as a common. If I will take x square as a common, then here we will get x, but in this what we will get? 23. I am using these two terms. If I am going to take x square as a common, what we will get in this place? We get only x, because 2x square is going to be common, and in this we get only minus 23, but we did not get our factor, because our factor is x minus 1, but we get x minus 23. It means we have to do some correction. How we will correction? We have to use splitting method. So I am writing this as x cube minus, because we have to remove minus 23 and we have to use 1, then how we can write 23 as a factor of 1? We can write minus 20x3 as it minus x square and minus 22x square. We can write, because if we add minus x square and minus 22x square, we get minus 23x square. So this one is our result. But now if we take these two terms as a common of x square, what we will get? In this place we get x, and in this place we get 1. So we get our first vector x minus 1. So it means we have to try to make all factor as a x minus 1 of all these terms. Now use this. We already solved these terms. Now our next term is 142x. If I am right here, 142x, and take common x, then here we will get 22x and minus 142. But again we did not get x minus 1. How we will get 1? X minus 1, if we make it as also to change in terms of 22, so that we can take 22 as a common. Please make a look. If I solve this 142 as a, if I am changing, 142 can be written as 22x plus 120x, because if we add them, 22x plus 120, we get 142x. So 142x can be written as 22x plus 120x. Now if we take common, in this we take common minus 22 and x, what we will get? Because 22 is going to be common and x is also takes common, what's the terms remains? X, and negative is also taken common, so we get here minus 1. So again we get a factor x minus 1. Now next term is what? In this 120x, and it remains 120. Now again we can take common 120. So I am going to take common 120. Here we will get x and here we will get minus 1. So in this all the terms we get a common x minus 1. So take common x minus 1 from all these terms. So I am going to take x minus 1 as a common. I will get here x square minus 22x and plus 120. So this one is our first factor, and this is a quadratic equation, and we can easily find out its factors by using middle term splitting method. Firstly, please make a note this, because I am using up now second method to find this quadratic polynomial by another method, which is called division method. Please make a note this. We get this same result by using another method, because this method is something complex and most of the students get puzzled how to make this factor and how to make splitting to get the same factor. So please make a note first. Now I am using second method. What you have to do? You have to make it as a dividend polynomial. So I am making a dividend polynomial. And what's our first factor is? X minus 1. Divide it. X minus 1. You have to divide it by x minus 1. And what's the quotient, which is same as that we already solved in our previous examples. Now do what we have to do, multiply. We already know how to divide it. First term is what? X cube. And here first term is what? X. So if we divide, what we will get? X square. So we have to use multiply by x square. Now do multiply x square into x, we get x cube. X square into minus 1, we get minus x square. Now the second step is we have to change the sign. Here the sign is positive, so we have to make it negative. Here the sign is negative and we have to make it positive. Now solve this. This is positive, this is negative. Same term, so they are cancelled out. Now this is minus, this is positive. Negative positive means negative. 23 minus 1, minus 22. So we get minus 22x square. Now remaining terms we have to write as it is. Minus 142x. Minus 120 Now our first term is what? Minus 22 x square. And divide is same. X is cancelled out with x. What we will get? Minus 22 x. So write here. Minus 22 x. Now do multiply the same. Minus 22 x into x. We get minus 22 x square. Minus 22 x into minus 1. We get plus 22 x. Now again change the sign. This is negative, we have to make it positive. This is positive, we have to make it negative. Now the first terms are same, but the signs are different. So these are cancelled out. Now this is positive negative, means we have to do subtract. 142 minus 22, we get 120 positive x, and this minus 120 as it is. Now what's the first term is here? 120 divided by the 120x divided by the x, we get only 120. So our next term is 120. Now multiply 120 into x, we get 120x. Now 120 into minus 1, minus 120. Change the sign. This is positive, this is make to negative. This is negative, we have to make it positive. Now both the terms are same, but signs are opposite. So these are cancelled out. We get remainder is 0. We get remainder is 0. So please look at this. We get the same answer as get previous method. What's the answer is? X square minus 22x plus 120. This is our the question, and you have to write the question. And first factor is what? X minus 1. So this becomes your quadratic equation, and this gives your another two factor. So you can do it by using middle term splitting method. So what are the factors? Please make a note and find out what are the middle term splitting method. What are the factors? Because if we multiply these, we have to get 120. And if we add them, what we will have to get? Minus 22. What are the factor? Minus 12 and minus 10. So what are the factor? Minus 12x and minus 10x. Because if we had minus 12x and minus 10x, we get minus 22x. And if you multiply minus 12 into minus 10, we get plus 120. So this is your final result. It's very simple. Now what's the common? In this we have to take x as a common, we get x minus 12. If we take 10 as a common, negative 10, we get same, because I am going to take negative, so it becomes also negative, x minus 12. Now in this what we have to take common? X minus 12. The remaining term same is x minus 10. So first factor is what? X minus 1, second factor is x minus 12, and third factor is x minus 10. So this one is your final answer. We did factorize the cubic polynomial and we get three factors. I hope you understand this concept, because we have to do the same concept in every types of question. But such type of question becomes very lengthy. You have to do very, very carefully. Please make a note first. If you really like my video, please do subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes and share it with your friends. Also press the button of like so everyone gets the benefits of this video. I completed my all examples of the exercise 2.4. Now we have to go to its exercise question. Now the exercise question becomes very, very easy, because we did all type of question, all type of concept that we have to apply to solve the exercise question. So we will meet with our next video for the exercise question very soon. You have to note it in your fair notebook, because most of the examples will put up in your final exams also. Please make a note and we will meet very soon. Thank you for once again for watching my video from start to एंड अगेन डोंट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब माई चैनल।